Today I am going to take the practical on the topic of spirometry. Requirement for spirometry recording: we required aseptic solution, mouthpiece should be rinsed thoroughly, give a proper instruction to the subject. These are the important things. And check the floating drum is moving properly or not. And before that, we want to pour water in it, then only floating drum will be works smoothly. And the aroma, and then the pulley, the chain, every setup should be properly maintained apparatus we want to take. Before we start with the parts, mouthpiece, the hollow tube which connecting to the spirometry, followed by floating drum, it is moves up and down. Whether it is working or not, the air is coming from the floating drum towards the mouthpiece. Next is the floating drum has a chain which is going towards the pulley. So your pulley has that marking, it start from 0, 500, likewise it is goes up till 6500. The unit of this is, next is there is a handlebar, we can adjust this up and down the level. So now we are going to record the column spirometry reading. Now there is an aseptic solution, rinse the mouthpiece thoroughly, and proper instructions we have to give to subject. After rinse that aseptic solution with the mouthpiece, I am going to give an instruction, Dada. Keep it in the mouth, close it and close the nose, and this is the way you have to perform it. Okay, relax, Dada. Now you see here, before starting there is a drum. The drum we have to do up and down, which means what, we are going to rinse the particular drum, whatever that gas or any air is inside, we are washing out. Now you keep it the lowermost position, and you have to keep it this. I hope you can able to see this fully. I am going to make it zero. Okay, now the person going to do normal quiet breathing. Zara, normal quiet breathing kara dada, slowly. Relax. After recording, you see the value, it is coming 500. So tidal volume how much? 500. So now you see that I have kept in the zero. Now you see that drum is lowermost. Now I am going to do ERV, that is expiratory reserve volume. Keep it in the mouth, close the nose, forcefully soda air. Okay, now you come and see the reading. It is your reading. How much it is? 0, 500, 1000, 1500, 2000, 2500. It is coming 2700. And the value is what? ERV is 2700. Now we are going to do IRV, inspire the air which is present in the floating drum. Inspiratory reserve volume, for that 0 I made in this manner. Now the pulley going to move anti-clockwise, so I will tell you how to record it. For this you see the drum is maximum level is I kept, drum will be move automatically, just hold it till the performance starts. Now you tell your subject, Dada, sagala sodun tumi gets, ready, kara. See, now you come back towards the pulley, we start with 0, now it is 4500. How to calculate this IRV? So 0, 500, 1000, 1500, 2000, 2500. Understood? When the pulley is moving towards down, we want to take this kind of reading. When you are doing ERV, keep this arrow mark this side, and that particular drum is moving towards up, so pulley will move clockwise. So directly what reading you are getting, that you have to write for ERV. Now precautions: once the person has completed the work, don't forget to rinse the mouthpiece with the help of aseptic solution. Once they have done, keep their particular apparatus properly and remove the water which is present in it. how to remove that? There is a knob and you want to remove. Next is floating drum. Before you are keeping or removing the water, rinse that air which is already present inside. Just move up and down carefully, otherwise the chain will get cut. Okay, and then don't forget to tell the subject to close the nose. That is very very important. They have to cover the mouthpiece properly, otherwise air will be leaking outward and your reading will be get affected. The subject should not see the reading. So the apparatus is here. The subject have to sit opposite to the apparatus. They should not see the readings, which is also give a proper result. If the person looking into the particular reading, you won't get proper reading. So now I will tell you how to get the reading properly. So come towards that apparatus, just rinse it before starting, and you should know if the drum is in the mid position, we are keeping in the zero point. Okay, when the drum is moving downward, it is known as inspiratory reserve volume. When the drum is moving upward, this is ERV, that is expiratory reserve volume. Why, sir, you are telling this now? So when you are keeping drum in the mid position, you will get your zero. So keep that point in the zero. Now the person going to expire the air, okay, which means they are going to blow the air into the drum. The floating drum will move upward like this. So certain point the drum will be stops. Whatever reading you have achieved, that is your ERV reading. Now what about IRV reading? For IRV, keep the drum maximum, the zero will come this side. Make this arrow in this manner. Now the drum moves towards down, and where the drum is stopped, what value you got, we want to take a reading, that is zero. Now 6500 become 500, this assumption. Okay, so now you see 500, 1000, 1500, 2000, and there is a 2 point. Each point is carries 100, so 2200. Okay, so this is the way we want to take a reading. Now I will show you how to submit this value. Now spirometry, in this what value we got? We recorded tidal volume, we recorded IRV, we recorded ERV, and from this we are going to take our vital capacity. So tidal volume, how much we recorded? 500 ml. ERV, how much? 2000 ml. ERV, how much? 2500 ml. So this value we got. What is vital capacity? Vital capacity nothing but tidal volume plus IRV plus ERV. So submit this value here, you will get this VC. So 500 plus 2000 plus 2500. What would be the value? You are getting 5000 ml. Now divided by 1000 to get what? Liter. So 5 liter.